Hello. Today I'm going to tell you about the Swiss Point of Care blood glucose meter. My name's Ben, founder of Swiss Point of Care. Let's start by taking a look at the box. We'll be unboxing it. Inside the box, there's everything you need for your first 10 glucose tests. Let's open the box and let's have a look what's inside. So I've put everything in front of me. Of course, there's the meter, the two little batteries that go inside. There's the lancing device and the lancets, which are the little needles, including an explanation how that works. There is the test strips and the control solution. And then there's quick start guide and manuals in different languages available. Do not forget, there's the warranty card, and it says here how to activate your warranty. Now I'm going to show you how to set up the meter. Now that the battery are in, turn on the meter. And the first thing it will ask you is to set it up, as you can see. So you have to choose the unit. You do that by choosing millimole or milligram. So you take the left button and you choose millimole, milligram. If you don't know what to use, look on our website. Millimole is mostly used in the Netherlands. Milligram is more used in Germany, so it depends on the country and what you're used to. By switching the little arrow, you can choose. And right now I'm going to put it on millimole and I'm going to press confirm here, and now it's set. Millimole, yes. Okay, the next thing is choosing whether you want a 24 hours clock or a 12 hours clock. So 12 hours would be AM, PM. I like 24 hours, so that 2 o'clock in the afternoon is 1400 hours. To confirm, you press the right button. Now you can choose the month and the date. In Europe, mostly day first, month is used, and you can see that written there. To confirm, again, press the right. Now we have the year, it's 2022, which is correct, so I press confirm. Now we get the month. To increase it, you press, and we are at the moment in November, and then press confirm on the right. Now we get the day, the 6th of November today, and I'm going to press S to confirm. Now you choose the time. It's 2 o'clock in the afternoon, and now the minutes, 10 minutes past 2, and I press on this side to confirm. The next thing is you can put a meal marker on. If you look carefully, you will see a little sign that looks like a bread. Right now it's off. I'm going to turn this on. What this will do is when you do your measurement, you can actually tell if it's breakfast or lunch or before or after. The next thing is what you see here is, do you want your glucose meter to beep when something happens? I like to keep it on, but if you want it off, you press on the left, off, or on, but we will leave it on. Press the right hand to confirm. The next thing is, do you want a warning if your ketone levels are maybe too high? For most people this is off, but depending on what your diabetes doctor says, you might want to put this on. If you put it on, you press it here on. For now, we will leave it off. The next thing is two warnings. The first one is a hyper warning, which you see there. You can turn it off or on. I will put it on. Again, press on the right hand side to confirm. And you can say which value you want the hyper to be alarming you off. I'm just going to leave this as default, but you can obviously increase or decrease that. Off for the hypo. In this case, I'll leave it off. But again, if you want to turn it on, you press it here to on, and then you enter your value or you leave it off for right now. Again, press here to confirm. Now you have the ability to set an alarm. This is especially important if you need to know and be remembered of when you should do a measurement. Time number one, as you can see, there's a little clock here on the screen, and you can choose alarm number one. You can put it off or you can put it on. If you put it on, like I just did on the left, you can press on the right to confirm. and you can say what time you want the alarm on. I will just do one example. Again, I'm going to say I will put the first one on at 8 o'clock in the morning. Again, with the right, I confirm, and I'll leave it at 8 o'clock. The second alarm, if you want, you can turn it on by clicking on the left, or you can leave it off, and I will leave it off. There's alarm number three, alarm number four. You have a total of 5 alarms that you can set. Now I'm going to show you how to use the lancing device and the lancet. Let's take a look at the lancing device, which looks like a pen, and the lancets, which are your tiny little needles. The top you can screw off by pressing here and then turning it around. This is the top, and this is then the pen. This is where the lancets go. So I have the lancets, as you can see, and I'm going to put it into the pen like this. Okay. Now you can take off the top part by turning that around. And now you can see it's in there. If you look closely, you will see the tiny little needle there. Now we take the cap and we screw it back on. Okay. One more step before you can use it. You will see that there's numbers written on here. These tell you how deep you want the needle to go. By turning that part, you can choose whether you want it on 0, 0.5, etc. Choose what works for you. Okay, so that's by turning this around. Now, before you can use it, you need to charge the lancing device, and you do that by pulling. So by pulling this part. If you then want to use it, you press this button. If I press that, you will hear click. And actually, the needle goes out and goes back in immediately again. So charge here, press here to use it. Now I'm going to show you how to do a test. To do a test, you need the glucose meter, you need the test strips, you need the lancing device, and you need a lancet. Here you can see one strip. It has a little circuit on here that goes into the meter, and this is the area where you collect the blood. So let's take the meter and let's put in the strip like that, and the meter will turn on automatically. Just wait for the blood droplet to blink, then the meter is ready. Charge the pen. You prick your finger on the side. You produce a little blood droplet. And now you take the meter with the test strip in and you hold it slightly against the blood droplet. And now you wait for it to count, 4, 3, 2, 1. And it now tells my glucose level 4.3 millimol. To eject the strip, there's a little strip ejector here so that you can just put it out and throw it away. Remember, the lancet is still in here. Open it, take the little thing that you had before. Put this on here, so that the needle is protected. And now also here you can use the ejector to eject that and throw away those two things. You're all done. Let me answer the frequently asked questions. Error E4. There's a few reasons that this can happen. It means either the strip has already been used or you have too little blood. Make sure that you first put the strip into the meter, wait for the blood droplet to start blinking, and then you can actually take the blood from your finger. Second reason can be that you actually put the blood on the wrong place of the strip. What you can see here, there is the flat end of the strip. If you put it on that, on the white part, nothing happens and it might generate an E4. Remember that the blood needs to go into that side so that with your finger and the blood dropper you touch with the end, and then all should be okay. If, for example, you have accidentally chosen millimole instead of milligram, or if you want to change your meal marker settings or other things, you need to go back into the setup. Let me show you how to do it. To go into the setup mode, you keep the right button pressed for 2 seconds until it turns on. You are now in setup mode. The first thing is you can change the unit. It says on millimole, as you can see at the bottom of the screen. If I press here, I can change it to milligram. If I want to confirm, I press here. And it says milligram yes or no. I'm going to say yes. And I'm going to confirm. Now the setting is changed to milligram. I still go through the other settings, which is 24 hours or 12 hours. The day or the month and the year, 2022, November 6th, that's the current date. And I can put the time, it's 2 o'clock in the afternoon, 40 minutes past. And every time to confirm here, I can have my meal marker again, press on the left to change it from on to off, press S to confirm, beep on or off or on to confirm. I can now have a ketone alarm. I will leave that off. I can have a hyper alarm. And if I want to change it to off, I press here. If I want to put it back on, it's here. Press on the right to confirm. It's set at 180 milligrams. I will leave it there. Press here to confirm. The hyper is off. I will leave it on off. And these are my alarms. I can say, okay, I want to change and put it on off, or put it on. If I leave it on and press confirm, then it will ask me what time. Here you can see at the top, you can see the hours. It says 8 o'clock. Maybe I want to change that to 9. I press on the right to confirm. And maybe I say I want it to be at 9:10, because that's easier for me. And again, press here to confirm. I'll leave the other ones off, but if you want to turn them on, you press left to change it to on or to off, and you enter the time just like you saw there before. You have 5 alarms that you can enter. Once you've entered the last one and you press again to confirm, the meter turns off, which means the setting is done. If you want to check if your meter is working correctly, you can actually do a control test with the control solution. You need the meter, you need the test strip, and you need this little bottle. What's inside this little bottle? Well, this is actually what's called control solution. It is a solution with a known level of glucose in it. And if you look carefully, then you see that the bottle has a number, which can be 0, 1, or 2. And in this case, the bottle is number 1. Let's do a test. We take a strip out of the canister and we put the strip the usual way into the meter, and the meter turns itself on. Just wait for the blood droplet to start blinking on the display. And now you take the meter with the strip in it. You slightly touch the droplet. 3, 2, 1. And we should have the results. 6.7. But how do you know if this is actually correct? Well, let me explain. Remember, the bottle had a number. This was number 1. If you look on the canister, on the back of the glucose strips, there is in the blue area control 0, control 1, control 2. And this is bottle number 1, so you have to look into control 1, and it has a range of 4.9 to 7.3. Now, our result was 6.7, so that's perfectly okay within the range of 4.9 and 7.3. So everything is good. If after the first 10 tests you want to do more, you can buy the test strips. These come in a pack of 50 with 2 of these little canisters, also called vials. There's two of them in there. 2 times 25 is 50. And you have the lancets. There's 100 lancets in a box. You can also order the control solution if you need it separately. Thank you for watching this video. Please give us a like. And if you have any questions, you can always contact our customer service at info@swisspointofcare.com. Good luck and bye-bye.